The British Columbia government will sue opioid manufacturers including Purdue Pharma in an effort to recoup healthcare costs associated with an overdose crisis that has swept the country and killed thousands, the Globe and Mail has learned. Attorney General David Eby and Minister of Mental Health and Addictions Judy Darcy are expected to announce the lawsuit on Wednesday at a media event outside the Supreme Court of British Columbia. The legal action is the first of its kind by a government in Canada. Until now, victims have attempted to seek restitution on their own, filing a class-action lawsuit against Purdue's Canadian operation that led to a proposed $20 million settlement, with $2 million going to the provinces and territories and no admission of guilt. That class action has since stalled. While courts in Ontario, Quebec and Nova Scotia approved the settlement, Saskatchewan did not, with Justice Brian Barrington Foote of Queen's Bench saying in March that he was not satisfied the settlement was fair, reasonable and in the best interests of the class as a whole. Nearly 4,000 Canadians died as a result of opioids in 2017, a 34% jump from the previous year, according to data from a new federal task force. In hard-hit British Columbia, at least 1,450 people died of illicit drug overdoses last year and another 878 in the first 7 months of 2018. Pharmaceutical giant Purdue Pharma will be named in the lawsuit, according to sources. Canada's opioid epidemic traces its roots to the mid-1990s, with the introduction of Purdue's OxyContin. Health Canada in 1996 approved the drug to relieve moderate to severe pain. Until then, opioids had been used primarily for terminal cancer patients. Canada is the world's second highest per capita consumer of prescription opioids after the United States. OxyContin was the top-selling long-acting opioid for more than a decade. At the same time, reports of addiction and overdose mounted among those who were prescribed the drug and those who used diverted pills illicitly. Purdue promoted OxyContin in North America as safer and less addictive than other opioids, encouraging doctors to prescribe the drug more widely for everything from back pain to fibromyalgia. The company has acknowledged in the United States that its marketing of OxyContin was misleading and paid $634.5 million US dollars in 2007 to settle criminal and civil charges. Purdue's Canadian operation has not made a similar admission of wrongdoing. Purdue said in an earlier statement to the Globe that it is deeply concerned about the opioid crisis. The company also said it has always marketed its products in compliance with Canada's rules, including the Federal Food and Drugs Act, FDA. In June, Purdue stopped marketing its opioids in Canada, in response to the federal government calling on drug companies to suspend marketing activities associated with opioids. Health Canada is in the process of developing policies aimed at restricting the marketing and advertising of the drugs. The federal government also has been facing growing pressure to launch a criminal investigation into the marketing practices of opioid manufacturers in Canada. Under the FDA, companies can be prosecuted for promoting drugs in a manner that is false, misleading or deceptive. A group of seven physicians and academics led by Nav Prasad, a family physician and researcher at St. Michael's Hospital in Toronto, sent an open letter to the Prime Minister, the Health Minister and the Justice Minister in April, urging them to probe opioid manufacturers. But no drug company has been prosecuted in Canada for misleading marketing in recent memory.